Welcome to the fourth edition of Bernama Today. Today we'll be speaking about positive energy for children, and there are reasons to suggest that we may need to adapt our mindsets and place equal to the importance of the right nutrition and physical exercise to grow healthy children. With me this particular morning, Nurul Ilyani Ahmad, who's a nutritionist with Nestle Products. Hi, yes, good morning,
hi,
and welcome
morning.
To the show.
Thank
now,
you.
We're going to talk about positive energy for children.
Right? Yes.
Now, maybe you can explain first the concept of positive energy.
All right. Okay, when we talk about positive energies, right, it's actually we are talking about a balanced right nutrition for the kids. So this positive energy, we try to actually make an awareness to the people. What is this positive energy is all about? It's actually about talking about energy you get from the food. You are getting from the right source, which is basically energy come from three main source of energy, which is from carbohydrate, proteins and fat. And when we talk about positive, it's actually talking about the right proportions we're giving to the kids. For example, talking about carbohydrate, the carbohydrate comes from 50 to 70% of the complete meals. 50 to 70% of carbohydrates actually coming from there, and then about 10 to 15 minutes from the protein, and about 20 to 30% from fats. That is what we call positive energy.
And the benefits of coming from positive energy, in terms of proportion, of course, different body size, different things, different,
Definitely.
You know, we need different things, right? How do we ensure that, like, you know?
Okay, we come with the positive energy in the proportions of percentage. It's very easier because even though you need, like, you know, you have bigger size than mine, for example, but still okay because this one is come in a percentage. So it applies for any types of body size, any types of physical activities that you've been doing, because it's coming a percentage. So basically, in a, if I take one plate, what I would say is half you need to fill with fruits and veg, another quarter with carbohydrate, and another quarter with the proteins, basically. So basically, that's the way it's supposed to be for positive energy.
So how do we look at our children's health day? I mean, like, you know, among children these days, how do we look at health? Because when you speak about whatever you've spoken about, half of it to be fruits, protein, and then carbohydrates, and the other one will be something. What again?
Yes, half will be fruits and veg.
Veggie.
Yes, another quarter will be carbohydrate.
Correct.
And the last quarter will be protein.
Protein. Yes. You see, but schools these days, canteens and all that, they don't really serve that kind of proportion. Or if they have that kind of proportion, it's not in the affordable range where the children can afford, right? You know, what's the situation among our children today, you know, from your point of view?
All right. Actually, we're working with University of Kebangsaan Malaysia, UKM. We work with them two times. Actually, we start in 2001, which is we just go there for first time to understand about students aged between 6 to 12 years old. How these people are doing, what is their dietary habits. And after that, we go again up in 2007. After six years, we go there and we try to see, is there any changes on their body weights, or they are still the same with the population 6 years ago we went. And then we found out, actually, they have a problem with their weight. About 30% of them actually having weight problem is either underweight or overweight. What is make us more concerns is on the overweight part, which is for even for overweight, we try to see whether the younger age, which is between 6 to 9 years old, right, how they are doing compared to the older children, which is between 10 to 12 years old. We found out actually 10 to 12 years old, they are getting more problems. They have good nutrition knowledge, but when it comes to attitude, they have a very poor level of attitude applying nutrition knowledge. And it's very scary because we found out, you know, with the incidence of obesity among adults, this could be some things that, you know, help help us to give a point that we need to do something. We can't just keep silence again.
Is this the fact or the point where implementation comes in play? Because you say information is there, but implementation is not, right? So, you know, when you talk about implementation, from your point of view, who should it come from? Will it come from the parents, teachers, or themselves?
I think we need to work hand in hands together because we understand kids spend most of the time in school as well. So it's also rules for teachers as well to educate on this part. But I would always believe it's always start at home. The parents itself have to do some things already. We need to create the moments, you know, the positive moments with the family. For example, when we get up in the morning, we need to actually have something for the kids as well. We can't just like let the kids go on empty, but at least if you know that it will be rushed, because from the same study, we also found out that kids telling us about 32% of them telling us that they are not having at all any breakfast. They're running on empty, totally on empty. Then we asked them, why you don't eat? They said it's because the first reason come out is really surprising us. It's because they said, we are busy, we need to catch the bus. I have to go with my moms, otherwise mom will be late to the workplace. So we, this is something that we know. They also have a busy life already starting in the morning. So as a parents, we need to do something. I think you don't have to be like struggle. If you never had breakfast at all before this, you can start with over the weekend, you know, because you have time over the weekend. Why not you come come a bit early, maybe 30 minutes, you prepare together with the kids, you create the positive moment with the kids together, and then start with the kids. I always believe it is important for the parents to study because kids will follow what their parents are doing.
So in your suggestion, right, what would be an early, you know, quick breakfast where somebody can just get grab and go, or you know, something that doesn't really take much time to do?
Okay, for example, you can just pack one cereals, for example, it doesn't matter, like Coco Crunch, all the cereals or whatever, you can pack in a Tupperware, and you can just give one UHT, where later they can just pour the milk or the UHT drinks in there, they can enjoy it. It's either in the bus or when they reach the schools. Otherwise, also it can just be like you just toast two slices of bread and then you scramble the eggs and pack nicely for them.
Right.
Yeah.
So with this revelation, right, what is Nestle doing to actually help educate not only the parents and the kids, but also, you know, the general public?
Okay, we come with Milo. Actually, we start the initiatives since last year as well. We have this Milo breakfast campaign. We actually call Malaysia to come together. Like for example, this year is going to be happening in Putrajaya. We call them to come together with us. We do a walk, a simple walk about 7 kilometers together. After that, we give them, we serve them with breakfast. We want them to feel how you feel when you start in the morning, you have some physical activity in your life, and you enjoy the breakfast. How's you feel after that, doing together? Because I always found out, you know, some people, they will just say that when you do it alone, you sometimes feel demotivated after a while. But when you do it together, you get the support from the others. Then you find like, oh, it's actually something easy to be done.
And it's very important to have support, because end of the day as well, if you look at yourself going to the gym, if you have a friend, you will definitely make it to the gym,
true,
right?
I'm agree with you.
And if you don't, you usually don't end up in the gym. Somebody like me. Right. I'm just wondering, right? Milo used to have, or Nestle, the company used to actually bring out green trucks to go to schools and all those kind of things. To actually not only offer the drink, but it's also to a little, you know, a bit here and there, educate the kids. You know, people like me used to have Milo trucks in my my schools. Does things like this still happen around here?
It still happens. And not only just we went to the schools, we also, nowadays we have kinds of like simple education, nutrition education for them as well. We are okay, previously maybe we just hand over a class to them only. But now we try to explain to them what we hands over to them is actually a cup of nutritious drinks, for example. How, what are the ingredients we use to make this cup of Milo, for example. And we also ensure that it delivers the positive energy in there. For example, we use Milo we made from proto malt, which is we extract from the malt of the barley. We ensure it's not only simple carbohydrate in there, we also have complex carbohydrate, which is the carbohydrate release the energy not immediately, but it's slowly, also slowly, more steady to the kids. We also put in skim milk to the to the car, mm. and we also have cocoa. Of course, mm. it's because when you talk about Milo, you know, I can't run away. I can't say that it's a good carb but without a good taste, because when you talk about Milo, it must be always start with the taste, because it's the taste that Malaysian love it so much.
And it's been selling by itself, right?
Yeah,
it doesn't need much people. But how do you go out there and educate people? Apparently, what I heard is that you have road shows and this and that. Maybe you can tell us a little bit more.
Actually, we have two types of road shows. Okay. We also have a concourse road shows. Mm-hmm. Now we done in Peninsula, Malaysia. We went to several places. Mm-hmm. In KL, we went to Johor Bahru, and now we are moving to East Malaysia, which is in Sabah and Sarawak separately. So what we have at these concourse events, right? We have a few platforms. Basically, we tell people what is this positive energy. Mm. We also have few interactive activity with them. For example, we have a cycling activity for them. Let them experience about, you know, when they do this kind of a little activity, how they feel about it, you know, with the congestion of it. And as well, together with this, we provide nutritionists to be there, also to educate with parents. Of course, parents want to know, okay, if I give this type of food to my kids, what it benefits my kids, and so on.
And then being obesity would be one of a problem. Would mouth nutrition be another problem as well?
I mean,
is it very common in Malaysia to have malnutrition?
Okay, from the same studies that we do it together with University Kebangsaan Malaysia, what we found, actually malnutrition is about 9%, but
so
the other,
not that bad.
Yes, but the other, as I'm not, I would say even 9% is something that still we put our eyes on it, but the more concerns is always about the overweight and obese, because we need to look at the incidence of or prevalence of obesity among the adults as well, because it's getting, you know, the trend is getting up and up, and the kids, which is going to replace us one day, is also, you know, having the same trend already. Are we going to have more obese people in this country or what?
Well, when you have all these burgers, you know, the big chunk burgers and all those kind of things, I think those are the things that would actually play back, because carbohydrates, end of the day, plays a big role in our Malaysians' life.
Yes.
You know, go anywhere, a staple in the morning, it's always rice, right?
Yes.
And so far, nasi lemak or nasi goreng has always been the staple food early in the morning. But when you say you want to change that, right?
Yeah.
In terms of you, of course, not only helping them to switch to a non-oily food and this and that, but when you speak about positive energy, you're talking about the proportion. Are you telling these people the proportion to go with? I mean, other than a plate of rice, a plate of rice could also, you know, I mean, it's different from different person's portions, right?
Yeah.
So, other than, you know, the percentage that you give me, 50% vegetables and fruits, a quarter of it would be protein, and the other quarter would be carbohydrates.
Yes.
Maybe there could be another way to look at it in a more easier percentage, or maybe, like, for example, 8 cups a day of water. Something like that. I mean, since you're a nutritionist.
Okay, when it comes to applying nutrition, I'm totally agree with you. It's not very easy, because if you apply but you not apply in the right way, and then you get to know all this percentage and you want to apply it, that's why I would say that I always go with the plate. What you can do with the plates, right? You don't scoop the rice first, because you know you will have high incidence of putting more rice on your plates.
Right.
Why don't you start scooping with the fruits and veg first? When you already half filled with the, your plate half filled with the fruits and veg, of course you have less space for rice and protein.
Right.
Then you can actually helps yourself to control on the portions. Okay. But what happened nowadays, if we go, for example, you know, even for breakfast, you go to mama and whatsoever, you will scoop the rice, the nasi goreng, you will scoop as much as possible. Then only after a while you say, okay lah, I take a little bit of sambal. Then sometimes we forgot about the eggs, the protein. Then you left it empty. Then you end up the whole plate is actually with all carbohydrates.
Yeah.
That's the proportion that we miss out, actually. Okay. Why don't later, you know, after this, we go, we take the protein
the fruits,
first. And then maybe there's a sayur of veg there, you take the veg and then you put the rice. Yeah.
Then it could make a big difference. Yeah. And probably it could. You know, you could try this out and then on a Monday morning, you know, away from all these flight stories and all this. And we are learning about something, you know, taking away from what Nurul here is saying, that you can actually put your veg first and then your protein and then your carbohydrates.
Yeah.
Maybe a few more things to say. You have any suggestions, advice, or maybe I don't know, maybe to tell the public before we go off air.
I would actually try to encourage, you know, try to not only kids, we do together with the kids as a parents, we do together with them to, you know, create the moment from the house. Find some times to actually eat breakfast with them. If they are seeing you doing that, they will get some motivation. It's because my mom is doing that.
Right.
And then explain to them, don't do something without explaining to them, and you give them some allowance. For example, allowance here means, right, you know, you try to apply nutrition or healthy eatings with your families, but you know your kids love nasi lemak, and you've been giving nasi lemak every day. Don't suddenly you just kill off nasi lemak from the list.
Right.
Of course, they will feel like, you know, my mom just changed, it's totally changed. Yeah. Why don't you start slowly, you give still give allowance. We still can enjoy nasi lemak, but maybe we're not enjoying every day, but we try to reduce number of frequencies.
Right. Yeah. Thank you very much, Nurul Liliani Ahmad, a nutritionist from Nestle Malaysia, telling us about positive energy for children. And not only that, we're facing what, obesity among children, what, 30%, right?
This thing, you
said 30 something percent. And malnutrition at what, 9%?
Yes.
And you get about give and take about 61% which is actually being healthy only, and you're looking to change all that to about 90 something percent to be really good. Thank you very much, Nurul, for coming in. Stay tuned because we have the Malay News up next. We've of course got more updates for you about MH370 and more about Malaysia next.